special. We'll have specials to tell you about them in the upcoming episode. Now, introducing my co-host, Andrea Honey.
Hello world, and welcome to Woman in Spaceflight.
Thank you. Okay, let's introduce Olivia Matthews to the room while we're letting people in.
Hello, I'm Olivia Matthews and owner of the smallest shit ever.
Oh, oops.
I'm flattered.
Welcome, Olivia. I'm glad that we're glad to have you on the show. We've heard that you know a lot about the very first women in space.
Valentina Tereshkova? Of course, my grandma was wonderful friends with that amazing woman.
Can you tell us something about Dr. Tereshkova?
Of course I can. That's why I'm here, dummy.
Oh, we've heard that you have some film footage of this amazing woman. Can you show us?
Of course.
Take a peek.
Hello, America, and any other people from other countries that happen to be watching this on Rerun or on YouTube. I'm Kitty Ock, and I'm here with Valentina Miss Valentina's Bostock 6. I have a few questions for you, Miss Valentina. Is that okay?
Of course.
Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm Valentina Tereshkova, and I was the very first woman in space. I knew the men in the space program thought that space would affect women differently. It was so unfair, and I was really honored when I was chosen to fly into space. I was honorarily inducted into the Soviet Air Force and hence became the first civilian to fly. So hey, Scott, take off your hat. I'm on my way.
Tina? Now, to be up in space is quite an accomplishment, but there were so many important helping hands on the ground. So let's move on to Katherine Johnson, the physicist.
Hello, I'm Kitty Hawk, and I'm here with Katherine Johnson. She has helped with many important space missions, like the Apollo missions and Friendship 7.
Hi, I'm Katherine Johnson, and I know many highly complicated math facts, like 1 plus 1 equals, hold on, I'm thinking. I got it! 2! Boom!
Never knew that!
Oh my gosh, you're a genius.
Just kidding! The real question is 49.38 times 89.60 divided by 1932 equals, math book please,
857.
Wrong page. 858. It is, if I'm correct, it should be 14 million. And, yep, 14 million. Yay!
Wow, Katherine Johnson really knows her math, but did you know she helped calculate and save the lives of the crews of Apollo 11 and Apollo 13, along with John Glenn's mission into space? Let's pass it on to Kitty Hawk, who is out with Sally Riot on the field.
Yes, you're on, go!
Hello, I am here with Sally Riot, the first American woman in space. So, Sally, how do I look? Is there anything in my hair? I mean, how do you think your flight into space has impacted all the little girls all around the world?
Hey, I'm Sally. I was born in California, and I became the first American woman in space. I was so lucky to be one of the 25 people of 8,000 to be hired by NASA. I went to the Johnson Space Center in Houston and trained in all sorts of things. Did you know that I can play tennis really well? You know, when I graduated from high school, I wanted to become a professional tennis player. Okay, you didn't answer any of my question, but can you tell us a bit about your amazing accomplishments?
You know, I was scheduled to take a third trip into space, but after the Space Shuttle Challenger disaster, it was sadly canceled. I earned a PhD in physics from Stanford University. You know, I was actually only the third woman to go into space after dear old Valentina Tereshkova and Svetlana Savitskaya. There are actually 2 elementary schools in the United States named after me. It's flattering.
Thanks.
Okay. educational. Now I'll pass it over to our hosts, Olivia Matthews, Nova Pierre, and Andrea Honey.
Thanks, Kitty. That's all for now, folks. Signing off from our base in Chandler, Arizona. Later, people. We'll see you on the next episode of Woman in Space Flight. Goodbye.
Dance party.
Hello, this is Katie Ack here with Dr. Mae Jemison on the ISS.
Hi, I became the first African-American woman in space above the Endeavor in 1992. I served in the Peace Corps from 1985 to 1987, when I was selected by NASA to join the Astronaut Corps.
What are some things that you like to do when you are not being amazing and famous?
In my younger years, I was trained to be a dancer, and I was on an episode of Star Trek even. I am terribly afraid of heights, and somehow I convinced myself to go into space. Excuse me?
What inspired you to go to space?
Well, my inspiration to go to space was to show what I can do as a colored person, was Martin Luther King Jr. And when I... Excuse me?
What?
And when I was in kindergarten, my teacher asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up, and I answered a scientist, and she replied, "Don't you mean a nurse?" That was another thing that drove me to fulfill my life to its full potential. And by that, I don't mean partying.
Thanks, Kitty. While we're on the topic of first woman for their country, let's talk about another great female astronaut. Everyone give it up for Kalpana Chawla. I was the first woman of Indian origin to fly in space. My first flight was on the Space Shuttle Columbia in 1997 as a robotic arm operator and mission specialist. And I was selected for my second space mission in 2000, only 3 years later, as part of the STS-107. I was very determined to become an astronaut, even in the face of the horrendous challenge of disaster in 1986. And I went on to earn a second master's that same year and a PhD in aerospace engineering from the University of Colorado at Boulder in 1988.
Wow, that sounds amazing. You need to give us one or two, or maybe 10 million fun facts.
Of course. I was really born on March 17th, 1962, but my parents altered my birth date to June 1st, 1961, so I could go to school earlier.
It's Olivia Matthews. Father!
Well, that's Kalpana Chawla, folks. Now, let's hand over to our field reporter, Kitty Hogg.
Thanks, Nova. I'm here today to your culture germ in Russia with the new Shansar. She's about to launch to go to the ISS on the Soyuz TMA-9 mission. Only a few months ago, she was notified that she was promoted from backup to crew member because Daisuke Genomoto became too medically ill to fly. Can you tell us that you're going to make this happen?
It takes hard work, concentration, and dedication to become a space tourist, though I prefer the term space flight participant. Training was hard, but it was all worth it. When I was notified that I would be in the mission, I was amazed. My friends and family supported me on this wonderful journey to space.
What do you hope to accomplish on this mission?
I hope to inspire everyone, especially the young people, women, young girls all over the world, and in Middle Eastern countries that do not provide women with the same opportunities as men, to not give up their dreams, but to pursue them. It may seem impossible to them at times, but I believe they can realize their dreams. They keep it up in their hearts, nurture it, and look for opportunities and make those opportunities happen.
Wow, did you hear that? I bet the world will be inspired by you. I certainly am.
I'm glad I got to talk to you.
Kitty Hawk.
I enjoyed talking to you, Kitty Hawk. Now I have to go suit up and get ready for my mission.
Isn't your launch in 5 hours?
It takes a while to get the spacesuit on, and we also can't use the bathroom for 16 hours, so we've tried to do that before we put our suits on.
Anish Ansari was born in Iran, experiencing the Iranian Revolution in 1979, 13 years after she was born. Later, she moved to America in her teenage years. Anisha received her Bachelor of Science degree at George Washington University in Fairfax, Virginia, and her Master's degree at George Washington University in Washington, D.C. She also co-founded a business with her brother-in-law and husband called Telecom Technologies, Inc. That's an issue. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Back to you, Nova and Angela.
Thanks, Kitty. While we're on the topic of first woman for their country, let's talk about another great female astronaut who was the first Indian in space. Everyone give it up for Kalpana Chawla.
I was the first woman of Indian origin in space. My first flight was on the Space Shuttle Columbia in 1997 as a robotic arm operator and mission specialist, and I was selected for my second space mission in 2000, only 3 years later, as part of the STS-107. I was very determined to become an astronaut, even in the face of the horrendous Challenger disaster in 1986. And I went on to earn a second master's that same year and a PhD in aerospace engineering from the University of Colorado at Boulder in 1988.
Amazing. Can you give us one or two quick facts?
Or a million. Yeah. Of course. I was really born on March 17th, 1962. But my parents altered my birthday. It was June 1st, 1961. So it's pretty cool.
Well, that happened to Miss Olivia Matthews' dad.
Well, that's the comic Charles goes. Now let's hand it over to our film reporter, Katie Cox.
What was
Phil 1, Phil 2? Stop it! Stop it!
Phil! Oh my god!
That fire. Feel better when I'm dancing.